that is one line of authorities you can see A, B, C, D, E. The other line of authority is P, Q, R, S, T, and O being the head of these two lines of authority. O has under him A, B, C, D, and E. This is one line of authority he has. The second line of authority, as you can see, is P, Q, R, S, T. If D has to communicate to S, as you can see in the diagram, who is in the same level, he cannot directly communicate to S in the formal organization. He has to traverse the route, that is from D, he has to communicate it to C, then B, then A, then it goes to A, then it comes to P, Q, R, then it is communicated to S. This is called the scalar chain. This is due to the principle of scalar chain being followed in the organization. Ninth principle is remuneration of employees. The overall pay and compensation should be fair to both employees and the organization. Remuneration should be just and equitable. This will ensure congenial atmosphere and good relations between workers and management. The remuneration for all the employees should not be the same. It should match with their performance. Employees, those who have contributed maximum towards the organization, should be remunerated maximum. On the other hand, those employees who have not contributed anything or whose contribution towards the organization is the least gets paid according to his contribution. When employees are remunerated fairly and equitably, they contribute to organizational efficiency. The next principle is order. According to Fayol, people and materials must be in suitable places at appropriate time for maximum efficiency. This will lead to increased productivity and efficiency. Men, materials, and machine and all other resources which are required for production process or any task required in the organization should be appropriately placed. For example, raw materials, machines, and workers who are involved in production process should be present in production unit. Similarly, employees taking care of other administrative tasks should be placed in their respective positions. This way, we can avoid unnecessary movements of men, machines, and materials, by which we can increase efficiency in production and also efficiency increase will be there in the organization. The next principle is equity. All employees should be treated as fairly as possible. That is, ensuring fairness to all employees. There should be no discrimination against any employee on account of caste, belief, or nationality, and equal opportunities are given to everyone to rise in companies. Every employee should be treated equally without any discrimination on account of caste, religion, language, etc. Managers should provide equal opportunities to all employees for their career growth and development, irrespective of different class sections and religion. So no discrimination should prevail in the organization. The next principle, stability of personnel. Employee turnover should be minimized to maintain organizational efficiency. According to Fayol, personnel should be carefully selected after rigorous procedure. Once selected, they should be kept at their post for a minimum fixed tenure. That is, unnecessary turnover of personnel. That is, unnecessarily employees should not leave the organization. So, unnecessary turnover of personnel should be avoided. So, firstly, the organization, while selecting personnel for various positions in its organization, should take every effort that they choose the right and the best candidate for various positions. Secondly, the employees should be motivated through fair remuneration, promotions, and also the management should take care of the employees' personal objectives. So the above may reduce turnover employees in the organization. So when the employees are taken care of by the management in the organization, we can reduce turnover of employees. The employees do not leave the organization. The next principle, initiative. Workers should be encouraged to develop and carry out their plans for improvements. It means taking the first step with self-motivation. But it does not mean going against the established practices of the company. Workers should be encouraged to take initiative, to take decisions to develop and carry out their plans for improvements. That is, the organization should allow the workers' participation or the employees' participation in the decision-making process in the organization. A good company should have an employee suggestion system whereby initiative or suggestions can be taken by the employees as well, which results in cost time reduction. The last principle, esprit de corps, that is unity in teamwork. Management should promote a team spirit of unity and harmony among employees. According to Fayol, management should promote teamwork, especially in large organizations. Otherwise, it would be difficult to realize its organizational objectives. Fayol says there should be team spirit and harmony among employees. A manager and the employees should coordinate, should cooperate, should work unitedly. A manager should replace I with we. You should always take the employees' decisions, cooperate with them, and foster team spirit and work towards the organizational objective. This will give rise to mutual trust and belongingness among team members, which will help in success of the organization.